Are you about to start your FE electrical and computer exam preparation journey? Are you intimidated by the vast number of exam topics and wondering how you will be able to retain all of the content for the exam day? In this video, I'm going to go over this challenge of content retention when it comes to FE electrical and computer exam. I'd like to start out by saying that the FE electrical and computer exam is not a test of your memory. In fact, on the exam, they give you NCS FE reference handbook, which contains a bunch of formulas, definitions, equations, and so on. So you might be wondering, if they've already given you all the equations, all the formulas, then what are they gonna test you on? Well, they'll be testing you on your understanding. So the better question that you should be asking yourself is, how should you approach content retention in the context of FE electrical and computer exam? In my opinion, the best strategy that can help you out with this is active recall. Active recall is a fancy way of saying that you should test yourself after learning a new concept or after reviewing a concept that you probably already knew. So imagine yourself reviewing or learning delta Y transformation for the first time. So you look at the equations, you get a sense of what is going on over here, and you tell yourself, you know, come the exam day, I'll be able to deal with delta Y transformation. No problem. The formula is here. I know how to work out the line voltages. I know what the phase voltages are, square root 3, divide this by that, angle 30 degrees and whatnot. I'll be fine. And if you just move on with this approach from one topic to another topic, chances are that you are actually not understanding it properly. And chances are that you're gonna fall short on the day of exam. Now let's entertain another scenario. So you're going through the delta Y transformation. You know that delta networks are very difficult to solve mathematically. And the better way to analyze three-phase systems is by converting the source as well as the load always in Y. This formula is not that difficult even to remember, but application is another thing. So at this stage, when you've understood why you need to do delta Y transformation, you know the formula, you know the math behind it, you just don't stop here. You seek out some practice problems and then put your understanding to test right away. Because during the learning phase, you're absorbing the content. So that is basically going in this direction. And that flow is outwards. And for effective learning and content retention, you actually need to go back and forth. So when you do some high quality practice problems related to delta Y transformation, not only you're able to jog your memory, but you're able to sort of cross-reference and cross-connect different concepts. And you may not be able to solve all of the problems, but that's not the point. The point is that the effort that you put in learning and then actively recalling the content, that will basically help you improve your level of understanding. As you probably know, I've authored several books on the topic of FE electrical and computer exam preparation. You can find them on Amazon and they're highly rated. In addition to that, I've also created an online program for FE electrical and computer exam preparation. And I deploy this principle of active recall in my exam preparation program. I have multiple lectures, over 250 lectures in the course, and pretty much after every single lecture, I include a quiz so that once you've understood the concept, you can actually get yourself tested with high quality practice problems and actively recall what you've learned. And I use this approach for all the exam topics, starting from math all the way to software. And you'd notice that up until this point, I haven't said that word, memorization, yet. Because as I mentioned earlier, FE electrical and computer exam is a test of your understanding. The formulas, the equations, variables, definitions, a lot of them are already in the reference handbook. So what you need to really do is to comprehend the concepts properly and be able to actively recall the content. Another thing that I strongly advise students to do is to sketch things out. And within my program, I help my students sketch and visualize concepts. Some of the questions, some of the concepts obviously cannot be understood without sketching. For example, circuit analysis, electronics, three-phase circuits, and so on. But when it comes to even some of the more abstract concepts, such as control systems, electromagnetics, linear systems, software, digital systems, even probability, I encourage my students and I actually help them understand these concepts through visualization and sketching. For instance, Bayes' theorem in probability, it is a complicated concept. And a lot of students just try to have a surface level understanding using the equation. But if you create the probability graphs and the bars, it becomes so much easier to understand what Bayes' theorem is all about. So whenever you have an opportunity, please make an effort and sketch and visualize. Translate the problem into a diagram. It may not always be possible, but there are more opportunities to do so than you realize. And this is a really good way to solve the content retention issue. Another very effective technique in terms of content retention and improving your understanding is breaking down complicated concepts into small digestible chunks. I am personally a big fan of learning things from first principles. In Mathy Electrical and Computer program, we make an effort to learn most of the concepts from first principles, but when it comes to my P-Power program, I actually go through multiple derivations. Because when you understand things from ground up, you don't have to memorize them. When you understand how each and every piece of the puzzle works, you're able to better cross-connect them. And there are always multiple levels of understanding. For example, if you take software engineering, if you don't have any background in software, what I tell my students is that at least get a good handle on the mechanics of software. And that can be sorting algorithms. Understand how bubble sort really works mechanically without really understanding the code yet. Once you get a big picture view of, okay, how adjacent components, how adjacent elements in an array are compared, and then eventually the largest item at the end of every single pass basically bubbles to the top, and the second largest item will bubble to the second highest spot after pass 2, and then third highest after pass 3, and so on and so forth. When you go back to the code, even if you have little to no understanding of software engineering, once you have those mechanics in your mind, it makes it a little bit easier. So divide the concepts into smaller pieces and take a stepwise approach, and then you won't have to memorize. So by equipping yourself with these study techniques, hopefully you won't have to rely on your memory, and the focus will shift towards understanding the concepts. And when you do that, you'll be better off. Because soon after passing the FE exam, you will be faced with another exam, which is PE Power exam for most of my FE Electrical students. And when it comes to PE Power exam, you're thoroughly tested on the depth of your understanding rather than your memorization. And the groundwork that you're doing right now, all the heavy lifting that you do in your FE Electrical and Computer exam preparation, at least 25-30% of that will carry over to your PE Power exam preparation. Please like this video if you found this content helpful and subscribe to the channel. And if you're looking for effective FE Electrical and PE Power exam preparation resources, please check out my website at www.studyforfe.com. If you like this video, then please don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Feel free to ask me any questions in the comment section of this video below. You can find tons of success stories of my FE Electrical and PE Power students over here. And if you want to learn more about preparation of FE Electrical and Computer exam and the PE Power exam, then check out these playlists over here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon in the next video.